Hi, this is Bruce Gabriel with 101 PowerPoint Tips for Business Managers. And today's tip is how to get an exact color match using ColorCop. Now, in the last tip, I showed you how to take a slide like this, where the slide title doesn't really pop against the background because the background is kind of gray, and turn it into a slide that looks like this, which the slide title pops a lot more and has a more optimistic view. Now, some question you might ask me is, how did I get the exact color to match? And the answer is, I chose a color from down here using a piece of software called ColorCop. And ColorCop looks like this. And what you'll do is you'll take the eyedropper and you'll hover over the area where you want to take the color, and you'll get an exact set of values so that you can match that color. So for example, I can go ahead to the Insert tab and insert a square that will cover this entire area. And I want this exact color match, so I go up into the Format tab. I'll get rid of the Shape Outline first. And I go to Shape Fill, More Fill Colors. And I go to the Custom tab and I make sure that RGB is selected, red, green, blue. And then I simply make the values here match the values I have up here. So red should be 207, green should be 74, blue should be 36, and you can see I get an exact color match with down here. In addition to helping me to choose the exact color I need, ColorCop will also gives you a palette down here which suggests colors that will go well with it. So for example, this yellow, if I click on that yellow, I'll get the exact values for that yellow. And instead of having a title that is black, I might experiment and maybe make the title yellow. And so you see, ColorCop is very useful not only for picking the colors and getting an exact match, but also for suggesting other colors you might use. Let me show you another example. Here's an example of a slide. It shows sales by country of different products. And I could make this slide pop more by taking the eyedropper in ColorCop and sampling the color from these flags. So I choose the red from the Canadian flag. I choose the blue from the Union flag. And I choose this saffron color from the national flag of India. And you can see that ColorCop saves these colors over in its color memory. And by looking at the exact values of these colors, which are given right here, and right here, and right here, I can change the color of these graphs, these bar charts, and you can see I get an exact match, and it really makes the slide pop. Let me give you another example. Let's say I'm presenting a slide like this, showing sales by city of different products that we sell. And this is the default color of the charts that Excel creates, but I could choose a different color. For example, I could choose a color like this. And what I've done is I've just gone on the internet and I've used, once again, the eyedropper to sample the colors of the different NFL football teams from each of these cities. So this is the green from the Seattle Seahawks. This is the taxi cab gold from the Green Bay Packers. And this is the scarlet from the San Francisco 49ers. So that's another creative way you could use ColorCop to add interesting color mixes to your slides. Let me give you one last example. Say you're creating a slide like this with this picture of an eagle, a bald eagle, but it's a vertical orientation, so it leaves a lot of white space on your slide. So I could try to create a square and try to guess what color this would be and try to make it match this this color over here. So for example, I know this is roughly gray with maybe a little bit of blue in it, and so I might guess that it might be a color something like that. That's a pretty close guess, but if I use this eyedropper in ColorCop, I can come down here and sample this color, and I can get an exact match that looks something like this. And so you see, not only have I got a more exact match on the color, but I was actually able to do it faster, less trial and error to find a color that matches. In fact, now that I have this eyedropper, I could try different things. I could try sampling the green from down here. I could try sampling the brown from this sign, the red from this sign, maybe the black from this eagle's wing. And you can see I have a number of different options of different side colors that I could use. And all of these colors would give a slightly different effect. But the important thing is that each of these colors harmonizes with the picture. And I have a number of colors that I can try that I know are going to work well, and I can get it done very, very quickly. Not only can I choose the color for the side, I could also use ColorCop to choose the color for the text. So rather than just using a straight white text, I could come over here and sample the color from this eagle's feathers. And down in this box here, you can see I have a range of different whites with different values that I could select from. Right. And if I apply one of these colors to the text, I could get a slide that looks something like this. You see the white now harmonizes with the color from the eagle's feathers. The red over here harmonizes with this red in the sign. So I have a slide that really harmonizes well. This is how it would look if the background I chose were red. In this case, I've chosen the black from the eagle's feathers. And here's an example if the slide were gray. And again, I've used the black from the eagle's feathers and the red from the sign over here. So Color Cop Note only helps you to choose colors that are going to harmonize and look really professional. It also helps you to choose those colors a lot faster. Color Cop is completely free. It's available for download from colorcop.net. As I said, it is completely free, but the developer does appreciate it if you give a small donation. I find a lot of value in Color Cop, so I gave my donation, and I do encourage you to do the same thing. I'm Bruce Gabriel. For more information about my book and more tips on creating clearer, more persuasive, and more professional-looking slides for the boardroom, you can go to speakingppt.com.